Welcome to this video. Are you interested in why your vehicle diagnosis displays P050E? How is the error code interpreted by the vehicle? What does P050E mean, or how to correct this fault? Today we will find answers to these questions together. Let's do this. First, let's look at the history of diagnostic fault code composition according to the OBD2 protocol, which is unified for all automakers since 2000. We divide the electric system of automobile into the four basic units: powertrain, body, chassis, network. This distribution is defined in the first character code. If the second character is expressed as zero, it is a standardized error. In the case of numbers 1, 2, 3, it is a more prestigious expression of the car-specific error. The third character specifies a subset of errors. The distribution shown is valid only for the standardized DTC code. Only the last two characters define the specific fault of the group. Let's not forget that such a division is valid only if the other character code is expressed by the number 0. Our website airbagreset.sk produces useful videos for you. You do not have to go through the OBD2 protocol anymore to know how to troubleshoot any car breakdown. You will find all the diagnostic codes that can be diagnosed in Mercury vehicles, also many other useful things. The following demonstration will help you look into the world of software for car control units. You unbelievably can move the video a bit further. The error code is split into two bytes consisting of 16 bits. One bit is the basic unit that each computer works with. The bit has two logical states: 0, low level, 1, high level. By combining the first two bits, the basic character of the error code is expressed. The next two bits again determine the second character. The last bit styles of the first byte define the third character of the code. The second byte is composed of a combination of 8 bits. The first 4 bits determine the fourth character of the code, and the combination of the last 4 bits defines the fifth character. A single byte conceals 256 possible combinations. We now know in what way the diagnostic tool translates the received information into a more comprehensible format. The number itself does not make sense to us if we cannot assign information about it to what it actually expresses. So, what does the diagnostic trouble code P050E interpret specifically for Mercury car manufacturers? The basic definition is cold start engine exhaust temperature out of range. And now this is a short description of this DTC code. The powertrain control module PCM calculates the actual catalyst warm-up temperature during a cold start. The PCM then compares the actual catalyst temperature to the expected catalyst temperature model. The difference between the actual and expected temperatures is a ratio. This DTC sets when this ratio exceeds the calibrated value and the malfunction indicator lamp MIL illuminates. This diagnostic error occurs most often in these cases: intake air restriction, exhaust restriction, engine mechanical concern, damaged or sludged electronic throttle body, ETB vacuum leaks, damaged PCM, disregard the freeze frame data. Freeze frame data does not apply to the cold start monitor. This DTC is informational only and may be accompanied by other DTCs. Diagnose other DTCs first. If no other DTCs are present, inspect the intake air system for air restrictions, vacuum leaks, and damage. If no concerns are present, clear the DTCs and verify the engine coolant temperature is below 378 degrees C, 100 degree F. Allow the vehicle to soak for 2 to 3 hours if necessary for the engine coolant temperature to fall below 378 degrees C, 100 degree F. Start the engine without touching the accelerator pedal and allow the engine to idle for 6 minutes in park. If no DTCs are present and the malfunction indicator lamp MIL is not illuminated after idling for 6 minutes, carry out the key on engine running KOER self-test to confirm that no DTCs are present and the repair is complete. The Airbag Reset website aims to provide information in 52 languages. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned for the next video.